Actually, I was here 2 days early because I was going down memory lane. Exactly 30 years ago that I studied here at Northeastern University. What I like to do with you is just to give you a little bit of background. First in the research, why did I start developing the High Performance Organizations Framework? And then, of course, tell you what it looks like and tell you some stories about high performance in real life.
Andre, I've been an organizational consultant and worked with organizations for many years, starting with a master's degree in organizational behavior. My real learning ground was 16 years with Procter & Gamble in the U.S. and in international, and then with some very fine consulting firms since then. I just like working with organizations and helping them get better results and help people have a better life and have more challenges as they work. When I first read your book, Andre, What Makes a High Performance Organization, I was struck by how your research findings correlated so well with the different things that I'd been doing with clients to try and help them improve their performance. The difference is you have statistically validated some key factors which now play very well with the kinds of tools that I'm using to help them get better results. Well, we've been approaching a potential client, a very good firm with very good people. What we really offer them and others is the best chance of any other opportunities to make lasting improvements in their organization to get better results. And we do that because of the evidence-based frameworks that we have and the experiences that we've had in a number of countries, in a number of industries and cultures that work.
He's been teaching and conducting research and managing projects in this field in all over the world. In fact, it's probably easier to mention countries where he has not worked than it is to mention those that he has. So it looks like the continent of Antarctica is where he has not yet worked. Pretty impressive resume.
In my book, Communications Informing, it's basically what I'm doing now. I talk, you eat. Basically. Maybe I ask you a question, I don't really listen to the answer because I need to get my message across. Okay? Dialogue is sitting down, talking to each other, taking each other seriously, and actually doing something with what you have learned. So I always say, if you never change your problems based on a dialogue, you never had a dialogue. I would like to test my audience. The conference organizers told me that important people are very nice. But are they also very smart? So the persons with their hands up there, can I see them again? You guys sit down, you're out of the game. The bonus is our what we call an extrinsic motivation, which kills the intrinsic motivation. In high performing, depends very much on that you want to become high performing, not someone tells you this. The more you empower your people, the worse your performance will be. Now that's an interesting moment. And you know what? We believe so much in you that if you decide to start your own company, we will give you $50 to start. If she gives you a she'll look at the family. So she goes back home, she goes to her family and says, you know, I'm finding a little bit of this awful employment. This organization is constrained people, and they even give me $50 to start myself. Who's the smart one now? I don't know, you didn't get killed, I didn't get killed, everybody had killed. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Don't accept mediocrity. Become a high-performance organization. We challenge because we know. Visit www.hpocenter.com.